Hello, 13th of July, and this is Dr. Tushar Shah, and we carry forward the investigations on an outpatient basis. In this talk, I'll talk about blood investigations. What blood tests to order in a suspected COVID-19? If the patient is below the age of 40, has no comorbidities, can be isolated at home, and is willing for not being tested, we do no tests that I already said. But one exception to this rule, and that exception is if the patient's fever lasts beyond 7 days, or if the patient's fever becomes hectic, meaning goes beyond 102, do investigate. Now you will probably do the basic investigations that we order for in COVID: CBC, CRP, D-dimer, beyond 7 days or high fever, and blood sugar and creatinine. If you have to order these. Of course, if you are not sure about your clinical diagnosis of COVID, you will order malarial parasite and, if necessary, dengue, NSO, or IgM. If you want to order BACTEC plus blood culture, urine routine, you can do that. Remember always when investigating that the patient, when he goes to the lab, is exposing the person accompanying that patient, is exposing the lab crowd, and therefore be reserved in asking for investigations. Second situation, if the patient is beyond the age of 60 or between 40 and 60 with comorbidities, which we classify in the same group, then you must investigate on the first day the patient comes to you. It may be the first day of fever. In this patient, you will do the same tests that I said: CBC, CRP, D-dimer, mandatory, blood sugar random, creatinine. If you are thinking of giving favipiravir, you must add SGPT and uric acid. If the patient has comorbidities, then instead of just the creatinine and uric acid, you might want to do the full renal profile if the patient is affording. If the patient has comorbidities, you might want to do the full LFT, not just the SGPT, if the patient can afford the tests. You will not do LDH simply because LDH is an inferior inflammatory marker to CRP. You have CRP, you don't do LDH. You won't do IL-6 and ferritin. Those are hospital-based tests. Please don't do ferritin and IL-6. In these patients, whether you want to do malaria, dengue, typhoid, you can decide depending on the clinical picture. I would not do an X-ray chest if my suspicion of COVID is strong, because I know that the X-ray chest may not be very sensitive. I leave the X-ray chest for in-hospital follow-up of the patient on a day-to-day basis for COVID pneumonia. RT-PCR is to be done, as we said before, on all 40 to 60 with comorbidities and above 60 with or without comorbidities. And HRCT is to be done if the RT-PCR is negative and you still suspect COVID. Or for some reason you can't recommend an RT-PCR. Though of course now the BMC in Mumbai has become liberal in allowing RT-PCR without prescriptions. So yeah, this is about blood tests, and a little more of this will come when we discuss hospitalization of the patient. Thank you.